Stratego, how to play. The object of the game is to capture your opponent's flag. Newer versions of Stratego reverse the ranking system. For these instructions, I will be using the classic rules. Setup. Lay out the board between the players so the name Stratego faces each of you. Each player picks a color and sets up their pieces on the closest four rows of their side of the board, so that the labeled sides face you and away from your opponent. If your version of the game comes with one, you may use the dividing screen to help mask your setup from your opponent. Only one piece can occupy a square at a time. Once both players are ready, remove the dividing screen, if used, and begin play. The red player moves first, then play alternates. On your turn, you must move one piece to an adjacent square or attack an opponent's piece on an adjacent square. If you cannot do either, then you immediately lose and your opponent wins the game. Pieces move one square at a time forward, backwards, left, or right. They cannot move diagonally, jump over, or move through another piece. They cannot move onto the same space as another piece unless they are attacking. A piece may not move back and forth between two squares for three consecutive turns. Only one piece can be moved per turn. The flag and bombs may not move or attack. The number rank 9 scout is the only piece that can move any number of open spaces forward, back, left, or right. When moved, the scout may only move in one constant direction until the next time they're moved. You may only attack opponent's pieces. To attack an opponent's piece, move your piece above it and tap it, saying your piece's number rank. The opponent says their number rank for their piece, and the higher number is captured and removed from the board and put back in the display tray. If the attacking piece won, it now occupies the space the defending piece held. If the winning piece was the defending piece, it stays on the same space as it was on when it was attacked. When pieces of the same rank battle, both pieces are removed from the game. Whenever a piece attacks a bomb, the attacking piece is lost and removed from the board, except if it is a number 8 minor. Then the bomb is defused and removed from the board. The letter rank S spy piece is ranked below all other pieces except the number rank 1 marshal. The spy is the only piece that can beat the marshal. If any piece attacks the spy, or if the spy attacks a piece that isn't the marshal, then the spy loses and is removed from play. If the marshal attacks the spy loses as well. The first player to attack the opponent's flag captures it and wins the game. If all your movable pieces have been removed, or you cannot move or attack on your turn, you lose. There are three tournament rule variations you can play with. Aggressor advantage. When pieces of the same rank battle, the attacking piece wins. Silent defense. Only the attacking player declares what his piece's rank is, and the defender removes the losing piece from the board. However, if the attacker is a scout, then the defender declares what piece it is. All removed pieces are kept hidden. Rescue. When you move a non-scout piece to your opponent's back row, you have the option of returning any one piece of yours to any available space on your half of the game board and end your turn. However, you may not rescue a bomb. You may only rescue two pieces a game, and the same playing piece cannot make both rescues.